Ambassador Oscar Herrera Gilbert. It's a pleasure to meet you.
It's my pleasure. Welcome to Ecuador Embassy and Ecuador Territory.
Thank you.
Let me introduce you with Ecuador Embassy.
Oh, yes, please.
Please follow me. Let me introduce you with this. This is a military attaché area where they develop military contacts and so on. And here you can find, the, from my point of view, the heart of the embassy, which is the trade pro-Ecuador office. Trade is one of the most important things in our budget as a mission here in Korea.
Ambassador, do you have some items that you can show Ecuadorian culture to our viewers?
Yeah, we have a very rich artisans in Ecuador. I can introduce you with this.
Yes,
if you follow me, please.
Yes.
It will be my pleasure. Let me introduce you with this. This is one of the most famous paints that made by Osvaldo Guayasamin. It's obviously a copy. And you can see the expressions of the, the paint. Mother taking care of his son, they express a lot of feelings. That's the style of Guayasamin. And the other is totally different. There used to be a famous artist in Daracro. In Daracro is a the sunset name of different students, but David Casiwanuk is who is the artist who made this. They learn from Endara Crow because it's very famous. The train is like a train flying the highlands.
Yes.
These very colorful towns, roof that's very clear is his style, Endara Crow style.
I see.
He dies young, and then his students took his style and become very successful also. The artist is David Casiwano, he's an indigenous, you notice for the last name, that the Guayasamin Casiwano come from the Ecuadorian indigenous ancestors.
I see, I see.
Yeah.
Actually, I've heard that when Prime Minister Inagyan visited Ecuador, he was very touched by Guayasamin's paintings, and he even suggested opening an exhibition here in Seoul.
We have been trying to do this Guayasamin exhibition here, but it's very expensive because each of these paints costs a lot, insurance and logistics. Didn't allow us to do, but with the Prime Minister's support, we are under discussions now, how many, how big, the size of the exhibition, and then create the budget to share with Korea how to do.
How exciting.
That's interesting. And finally, we can achieve this dream that we have since we arrived here.
Ambassador, I see a lot of items from Ecuador. Could you explain for our viewers, please?
Let me introduce you with the Monte Cristi hat, well known in the world as a Panama hat.
Right, that's what I know too.
Yeah, but the problem with this is why the world knows as a Panama hat? Because when the Panama Canal was inaugurating, the president, U.S. president, during the very sunny day, he loves this hat, and he asked that if he used that hat in that day. If you see the picture, he's using this, and then everybody start to ask where it come from, what that hat, where it come from, and everybody start to say in Panama. Hat from Panama, hat from Panama, Panama hat.
That's how it got the name Panama hat.
But in fact, it's made by a natural straw,
it's
made by Monte Cristi, Monte Cristi, Manabí province in the coastal region of Ecuador. This is my personal
You look great.
My style. Thank you. And you can see here, exclusive for Ecuador, Oscar Herrera Gilbert. And this is a tagua. It's well known as tagua. Tagua, this is the pepa tagua, the raw material, and it's well known as ivory the vegetable, ivory, because as soon as you polish this, you can obtain this product. It looks like ivory. It comes from the tree, it falls from the tree, and the people harvest, and the artisans do all of these things, like Galapagos from Galapagos Island, the turtle. They use all of these Ecuador landmarks to create these artisans and sell.
Ambassador, thank you very much for all the preparation and explanations as well. Shall we move on and talk a bit more?
Well, it will be my pleasure. If you ask me another questions or whatever you need, just let me know.
I will. Ambassador, thank you very much for joining us today.
It's my pleasure to have you in Ecuador territory.
So I know that you worked as a trade office director, and then you were appointed as the ambassador to Korea. It's been already a while, and what do you think makes Korea attractive?
As Ecuadorian, Korea has an amazing imagining in Ecuador. First, we start, I don't know if you are aware that the first car that Hyundai export to the world went to Ecuador. The first pony.
I will
show you in a book that I made in 2012 when I was Sambugan. I'm telling this because we start the process to know about Korea with that pony. Hyundai, Kia, is the number one foreign market in Ecuador vehicles. In sales, Ecuador sales vehicles. And Samsung, for instance, has 50% in smartphones. LG has the 70% of the market in TV screens. And it's very clear that Korean is well known in Ecuador as a high quality products. Now we are bringing, not now, in the last 5 or 6 years, at least 700 Ecuadorians come through these embassy scholarships and with Korea support, government support, with private sector support. It's not just with the government relationships. And we have a commitment with them. We call Ambassadors Project. What it means is the commitment that they have to, when they go back to Ecuador, they have to spread the experience here in order to encourage their other friends to come to Korea.
I see.
Then with drama, Korean drama is well known in Ecuador. Korea K-pop is very famous in Ecuador. All of these create a very extraordinary imagine for Korea in Ecuador. That's why it's easy to come. And I think the outcome with these students and is the outcome of this very good imagine that Korean and Koreans, Korean culture has in Ecuador.
I see. Speaking of providing and receiving support and exchanges, I think our history began a while ago. And I know that Ecuador provided a huge support during the Korean War. Would you explain more about this history between our two countries?
Ecuador, in the history, is a peaceful country. That's why we chose the option to send not armament, instead to send a supply, a food to support the Korean citizens during this very hard time that you were going through. Not just that, in UN, we support the recognition that UN made to South Korea. And we always have been supporting Korea, development Korea process. And I think Korea has reciprocated this in a huge manner through cooperation in Galapagos Island, in different fields, in knowledge transfer. They bring 120, 150 public employees, public members to receive seminars here by Korea COICA budget. It means the government. That's why we have to recognize the extraordinary support that we have been receiving from Korea, inclusive, as I mentioned, President Moon, following the Korea culture. It was a very interesting experience for me to have the President Moon in my office in June 2016, mm-hmm. before he became president, mm-hmm. a few months before, mm-hmm. because he brought mm-hmm. his personal donation, mm-hmm. and he bought me because he came without media. He came just by himself mm-hmm. with his personal donation mm-hmm. to support mm-hmm. Ecuadorian process to try to overcome the earthquake that we suffered in the first months of mm-hmm. 2016. Uh-huh. That's why I think I am the only ambassador who has a picture with the Korean president in my office.
Before he became the president.
Before he uh-huh. became, but uh-huh. my colleagues didn't know that.
You just briefly mentioned 2016 earthquake in Ecuador, and I heard that there was a really big devastating damage at the time. What kind of support did Ecuador receive from Korea?
As soon as we received that information from Ecuador, I made a press conference. Mm. And mm-hmm. we received a lot of support from Korea media. I was expecting maybe 5-6 channels. Mm. No, more than 40 reporters in. Mm-hmm. There were no room for that amount of mm-hmm. Reporters. Mm-hmm. We received from private people, companies who has relationship with Ecuador, and another who has a relationship with mm-hmm. Ecuador, just to support our mm-hmm. country. Mm-hmm. Korea, obviously, Korea government make a strong donation, and it was an extraordinary reaction from Korea. It means that when you mention our history, this part of the history, in this case, reciprocating our behavior mm-hmm, in the mm-hmm, past. Mm-hmm. Korea has been an extraordinary mm-hmm. performance with Ecuador. And we are very thankful for that.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm, I see. Now let's talk about congenial relations between our two countries. So Korea and Ecuador established our diplomatic ties in 1962. How are the exchange relations between the two countries now?
For instance, the best signal is your prime minister went to Ecuador 2 weeks ago. Mm-hmm. Is the highest authority, Korean authority, who visits Ecuador in the history. They're receiving a lot of support from Korea, and in Galapagos, for instance, Korea has created 2 plants, renewable energy, in order to keep this UNESCO treasure as Galapagos is in environment clean conditions. For Ecuador, it's a priority to keep Galapagos in those conditions. And Korea has, I think, is one of the best countries who are doing the major effort in order to support the Ecuador decision to keep these islands in that conditions. We are in the one of the best moments in our diplomat and different fields mm-hmm. situation.
Mm-hmm. So since you worked as a trade office director, how are you evaluating the economy relationship between our two countries?
It has been good. Our export growth from 10 million to 160 million in a few years. And now we are sending here, for instance, Ecuador sew, Ecuador shrimp. It has more than 35% of this market belongs to Ecuador shrimp. When I started the process, nobody knew about Ecuador shrimp. Mm-hmm. I went to Garak Market to knock the door one by one mm-hmm. as a samuga, tried to sell our products, mm-hmm. and few people knew at that time where is Ecuador, what have Ecuador, mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. and I have to explain one by mm-hmm. one. In 2011, mm-hmm. I tried to sell. In 2012, the people come to buy. It was totally different. Then we bring bananas. Mm-hmm. Ecuador is Banana Republic, you know. Mm-hmm. We are number one in the world. Despite it's not easy because we don't have FTA still mm-hmm. under negotiation mm-hmm. with Korea. Mm-hmm. Despite the distance, mm-hmm. the tariff, we are more than 35% mm-hmm. in mm-hmm. the shrimp market in Korea. Mm-hmm. And in bananas, we are growing day by day. Definitely mm-hmm. is because of the quality of our mm-hmm. products. Mm-hmm. And it has been a very amazing experience, this process with Korea. Mm-hmm. We have a double taxation exception agreement with Korea. And we are under negotiation, we call SECA. Mm-hmm. It's a kind of FTA. We already have five round of negotiations mm-hmm. between our countries. With that agreement, definitely we can raise the our exportations to Korea, mm. and obviously Korea will raise the exportations to Ecuador.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm, I see. Speaking of Prime Minister Inagon, as you mentioned, he made the first high-level visit to Ecuador. What kind of discussion were made during his visit?
We talked about different fields, cooperation, for instance, Galapagos projects and environmental projects in Galapagos, because despite the boat projects that Korea has been accomplished so far, there's another projects on the way with Korea's support. And he totally assured that Korea is going to support these different environmental projects in Galapagos Island and in Ecuador, England. And the other field was trade, very important thing. And he compromised his effort in order to restart the process as soon as he came back to Korea. And he was part of the cabinet meeting in the mm-hmm. palace. Mm-hmm. I think first time that I heard that one of the foreign authorities was part of the cabinet meeting with the president and all the ministers was unique.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm, I see. Ambassador, I'm also curious about your activities here in Korea. And I heard that recently you experienced a very unique one as well. You took part as a runway model for a fashion show, and our team was also there to check it out. So let's take a look together.
People are busy rehearsing for a fashion show that'll reveal the official uniforms for this year's biggest event in aquatic sports, the 18th FINA World Championships in Gwangju. In this crowd of professional models, attention is on the Ecuadorian ambassador to South Korea, Oscar Herrera Gilbert.
Korea asked me to be part of this event, and I think it's the best way to support Korea's request, be part of this.
Ambassador Herrera and his wife will take to the runway themselves, also wearing the official uniform of the Gwangju 2019 FINA World Championships. It'll be their first time on the runway, but there's no sign that they're nervous. What they'll be showing off is the uniform for affiliates of the International Swimming Federation. The ambassador is busy polishing his walk and his poses. One essential for the fashion show is partnership, so the ambassador and his wife are exchanging a lot of ideas.
When I see the suit, it looks the color. It's very colorful. It's a blue electric light, and means that I think they choose the color because of the watercolor. It's very interesting. When I see, I like it.
The FINA World Championships are held every 2 years and are organized by the International Swimming Federation. This year, the World Championships will be held in Gwangju.
With passion that goes beyond limits.
The event finally kicks off. It's a full lineup today, including the fashion show, performances, a ceremony to appoint an honorary ambassador, as well as an event to showcase the medals that'll be awarded to the champion swimmers. Ambassador Herrera and his wife are making their last preparations for the main event. Finally, the fashion show begins. The models showcase the uniforms to be worn by the executives, referees, and agents of the International Swimming Federation, as well as a more casual sports uniform to be worn by volunteers. Now it's time for Ambassador Herrera and his wife to take to the runway. They're not professional models, but on stage they look as comfortable as can be.
맨 처음에는 이제 대사님 어느 대사님을 해야 될까 고민을 했었는데 저희 초청장을 받으시고 제일 먼저 연락을 주셨어요. 박수도 많이 받으시고 되게 저희 조직에서는 굉장히 감사 인사를 아까 시장님께서도 직접 드렸거든요. 그래서 네, 굉장히 저희도 영광이라고 생각합니다.
Around 200 countries and more than 7,000 participants are taking part in the Gwangju 2019 FINA World Championships, making it the biggest edition yet. With support from Ambassador Herrera and many others, we're hoping for big success at this year's World Aquatics Championships.
Was there a special reason that you decided to take part for a fashion show?
I have to recognize what this was a surprise for me. I didn't expect to a fashion show. But my decision was based on the to spread, as I mentioned, the Ecuador Imagine in Korea. And I think this is one of the good ways to reach another segment of the Korean market, for to say something in some way. Because there's youngsters, there's a middle age, there's a thing, and this is a worldwide, and why not? This is a unique occasion to do this for my country, and I did it.
I see. Ecuador is called a little heaven on the equator because beautiful nature like Amazon or Andes mountain range or Galapagos Islands. Besides all of these famous beautiful spots, are there more attractive hidden gems in Ecuador?
Yeah, definitely. The good thing in Ecuador case is as a small country, but you got everything. You got four regions: the coastal region, the highlands in the middle, with the highest active volcano in the world, Cotopaxi, 6,500 meters, with the Amazon heart in 30 minutes more. If you go to Brazil, maybe from Rio to Manaus, you need 5, 6, 7 hours by flight, by plane, to reach the Amazon, maybe 3 hours or in Peru. Here in 30 minutes from the coastal region, you reach the capital in front of this active volcano. Is huge. And is throwing stones is unique experience. And there is several mountains, not just Chimborazo is the highest mountain in the world if you measure from the center of the earth. And you can reach the Amazon in 30 minutes more. And you have in Galapagos in 1 hour and a half. That's why you got everything. And the best downtown now is a UNESCO heritage also is a Quito downtown. If you want to see the most beautiful churches that had more than 200 years, just go to the capital. They're amazing. La Compañía de Jesús, very famous near to the palace, and different options in Quito downtown. The people who likes the culture and then go there is a trip to the history in Ecuador.
I see. Ambassador, I believe this is my last question. What are your plans to further promote Korea-Ecuador relations?
One is bring YSMIN exposition to Korea. I think is one of the key issues that we can put in the, because of the, based on regard of the importance of the artist. And doing in the same way to organize, continue organizing cultural events, like movies, events. We organize South American cinema and worldwide cinema. And continuing doing, be part of the fairs, be part of the seminars are here. And to invite Koreans in different ways to be part of this, it's not just one thing that we have to do. I think we have to do several. And one of the key issues could be we are trying to organize a fun trip with Korean reporters to go to Ecuador to visit this paradise in order to let Koreans, when this fun trip come back to Korea, you can spread these beautiful views and landmarks that you are going to see in Ecuador among Koreans. No? That for me is the key factor to spread Ecuador Imagine here.
Ambassador, thank you so much for your time today, and I really look forward to your future activities here in Korea.
No, I have to express my thanks for your visit, and it has been amazing to share with you.
Thank you.
Welcome.